what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about the Grid Geometry Manager in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, everybody, let's talk about the Grid Geometry Manager. Well, because we have to. This is a useful way to organize widgets within a container. Imagine our windows being arranged into a series of rows and columns, similar to an Excel spreadsheet. I tend to use that example a lot. The top leftmost cell is row 0, column 0. Computers always begin with 0, so that's why our grid doesn't begin with row 1, column 1. And we can list which row and column we would like our widgets to be placed within. And by default, we only have one row and one column to work with at the start. But we can explicitly state which row and column this widget should be placed within relative to the container that it's in. And Python will create new relative rows and columns for us if we state where these widgets should be placed. So let's create a small submission form and then organize all of our widgets using our new grid system that we have. So let's begin by creating a window, window equals tk followed by window.mainloop. Now that we have our window, we'll need to create some widgets to add to this window. So let's say that we want an entry box and a label for a first name, last name, and email address, as well as a submit button. So let's create a label and an entry box for a first name just to demonstrate this. So let's call this label firstNameLabel equals label. We're adding this to the window, and let's set the text to firstName. For now, I'm just going to use .pack to demonstrate the differences between pack and grid. And let's create an entry box. Let's call this first name entry equals entry. We are adding this to the window. And for now, we're just going to pack this. And let's take a look. So here's our label on the top. It says first name, and then it has our entry box right underneath. So what if we want to have this label on the left-hand side and our entry box on the right-hand side of the label? We're better off using the grid geometry manager. So we're going to replace pack with grid. And we have to set which row and column that we want each of these widgets to be placed within. Normally, if you use the pack geometry manager, as you create new widgets, they're just going to be placed directly underneath in one long column. So let's say that for our name label, we want to place this where the row is 0 and the column is 0. That's the top left corner. So within the grid geometry manager, when we call it, we're going to set row to equal 0 as well as column to equal 0. And then for the first name entry, we want this to be on the right-hand side of our label. So we'll place this within the same row. Row equals 0, but in a different column. Column equals 1. So column 1 is directly to the right of column 0. And then when we compile and run this, we now have our entry box to the right of our label that we have. So let's repeat the process for a last name, an email address, and then a submit button. So I'm just going to copy what we have here and change first name to last name. So last name label, and we'll change the text to last name. Last name entry, and we'll keep that the same. Now we want this last name label to be underneath the first name label because right now they're going to overlap because we have them in the same row and columns. So you can see that we can no longer see the first name label or the first name entry. So let's place this directly underneath. We're going to put these underneath by one row. So we'll keep the columns the same, but we're going to put this underneath by one row. So row 1 and row 1 for the last name entry. And what you get is that these two labels and entry boxes are arranged neatly into rows and columns. And let's do the same thing for an email. So I'm going to copy what we have, and we're going to change last name to email. So email label and email entry, and then change for the text last name to just email. And we're going to place these where row equals 2, and we'll keep the column the same. And for email entry, row 2, column 1. So doesn't that look a lot better? Now let's create a submit button. So let's call this submit button equals button, and then we're adding this to the window, and we should set some text. Text equals submit, I guess, dot grid. And we want to place this underneath. Currently kind of just shoves it underneath for now. Let's say that we want this between these two columns. So we'll want to set the row and the column to begin with. Row is going to equal 3, and column, we'll set this equal to 0 for now. There isn't going to be any apparent change. It's still going to be in the same place. But one thing that we can do is use an option called columnspan. We can have a widget take up more than one column, and it's going to place this widget in between both of these columns, in between the combined width of both of them. So we'll add columnspan equals 2. So this widget is going to take up the next two available columns, including the one that it's currently in. And you can see that our submit button is now between these two columns that we have. One thing that you should know is that the column width is dependent on the width of the largest widget that is contained within that particular column. Let's say that we increase the width of our first name label. Well, our column is going to expand to actually fit that widget that we have. So for our first name label, let's set the width to maybe 20. And this is going to increase the width of column 0. And to even better demonstrate this, let's color each label a certain color, just for a visual. For our first name label, let's say this is red. And then for our last name label, let's set this to green. And then for email, maybe blue. Now all of these are color coordinated, and you can see that the background color of our first name label is taking up the entire column space. Now what if we changed the size of our email label to something even larger, like 30? So width equals 30. And now the column 0 has expanded to accommodate the size of our largest widget, which is our email, which has a width of 30. And before we finish this video, let's add a title to the submission form right on top of the first name label and the entry label. So let's call this title label equals label. We're adding this to the window. Let's set some text. Let's say enter your info. And let's pick font. Font equals, what am I feeling like today? Maybe just Arial. And then a size, maybe 25. We're going to use the grid geometry manager. And we want this at the top, so we want row 0 at least. I want this to take up two columns. So we'll say column equals 0, and then set a column span. Column span equals 2. Now, a few things are going to overlap here. So we're going to move everything down by one row, besides our title label. So we want this first name label to be directly underneath our title label. So let's move everything down by one row. And our title is going to be directly on top of our first name label, as well as the first name entry box that we have. Alright, so that's the very basics of the grid geometry manager. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the grid geometry manager in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.